Definitely recording.
Okay. Hi everyone, I'm Melissa from Fresh Blooming Clothing, and this is my mom,
Karen from Lavender Clothesline.
And she's here visiting me from Pennsylvania to Florida, where I live, and we thought it might be fun if on her vacation, instead of the beach, she came to the Goodwill bins.
And went thrifting together.
Was it fun?
Yes, yes, it was very fun.
Probably educational, too.
Yeah, a little bit wild, but it was good.
Good. Different from your bins, I'm sure.
Yep.
So we thought we would show you what we got. I spent about $41.
Did you?
Oh, that's
good. Okay, mine was about $10 because I did not bring a suitcase loaded on the plane. What is that called? Not carry-on.
Checked bag.
Checked. I did not bring a check bag, but I said to myself, if I found good things here, I would thrift a suitcase and load it up and pay for the suitcase back. So we've yet to see how that's going to work out.
Yeah.
So far, I've picked up stuff, so.
Just good stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll start.
Okay.
We found a friend named Mark, who was bringing us a lot of different items over. So thank you, Mark. One of those was these Victoria's Secrets kind of purple, shiny swimsuit bottoms for a girl. I'll probably get $7, $10 out of them, I'm guessing.
Yeah. And so lightweight, too.
Yeah.
And what did we pay per pound?
$1.69.
Okay.
I think it's $1.69.
Yeah. So those probably weigh like 3 ounces. So somebody out there do the math and that's what she paid.
Yeah. Okay. Very lightweight.
Yes.
You want me to go again? Or?
Yes. You
okay.
Go again.
Next is something actually you found and gave me is Threshold, which is Target brand?
Yes.
Target brand, and it's a tablecloth in kind of a light pink color.
Ugly pink.
Light pink.
It's dusty pink.
It is kind of a dusty pink.
We all had this in the 80s.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you put this on a table with like a crochet doily tablecloth over it, and did teacups and stuff, this would be gorgeous.
That would be very 80s again. Maybe because I really experienced the 80s and it wasn't a cool thing to live it all over again.
Yeah, I don't know. What do you think? It's pretty. I like it. Maybe 10 bucks.
I'm sure they're all rushing to buy your...
Yeah.
Your Threshold tablecloth.
This is just going to be a whole bunch of tchotchka before we get to the clothes. This is a Webkinz monkey. We have no idea how he got in our bag, nor did we know we bought him. So we'll look him up.
I think in the thick of things, I found this, and I said, oh, look at this. Do you know stuffed animals? And then I just put it in her cart, and
yes.
We got to. So,
but it got crazy toward the end.
It did, a little bit.
Yeah, but we're going to look him up. He's cute.
Yeah.
You want to pull something out?
Okay. One of the first items I found was this down vest. It's a men's outdoor vest by Eddie Bauer. And normally I don't really pick up Eddie Bauer. It doesn't do too well for me. But what attracted me to this was the label. I've never seen this Eddie Bauer label before. Anybody has seen that label, if you can see it. So caught my attention because of that. And it had another label inside. And it's considered a premium down, 550 fill power. Premium goose down. So, so I'm going to take a chance on this. Quilted, zip up, men's.
Yeah. I bet you it's still on their website. You can see what it retails for.
You think, or you can Google image it. I usually try to do that and see what, but I'm actually going to put this on for $34.99.
I'd put it on for higher.
Oh, you would?
I would. These usually retail for about $80, $90.
For Eddie Bauer, though?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe I'll for more.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Okay.
What is this, like 2 pounds, maybe?
Yeah, that probably cost about $4.
Okay.
Next up are a whole bunch of nothings. Then I'm going to keep until the holidays some stickers, a tin for a gift holder, receipt organizer for myself, and a book for my 8-year-old's niece that's American Girl. She likes American Girl.
That's so cute.
And also for her, fun mineral and fossils, but really for me. I'm going to go through this before her because I love this.
Do you want to keep this?
I do want to keep this.
Okay.
I want to find these out in the open. How fun.
And what's that called? Without looking.
Agate?
Yeah, I think that's right.
Okay, let me do another one.
And it's an agate slice.
Oh, it's a slice.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's a whole bunch of different crystal formations and turquoise and arrowhead. And
oh, what does this say? Somebody actually found it.
In the UK?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm very impressed.
Yeah.
But I think she'll have a blast. I don't even know what that is. Going through that. I remember in the backyard where we lived in New York, mining for things like this.
Digging for treasure.
We'd find little gravel stones and nothingness, but very cool.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Here, you can do this one.
This is new in package, and I didn't know what it was, but if it's new in package, it has my attention. So this is Back Trails Adult and Up. It is a helmet visor. So if you are a cyclist and for some reason you need a visor, it's almost like a spoiler for your car. Oh. I think it just creates that wind draft. Is that what that's called?
Probably.
But again, we did not look it up. But
yeah,
this thing probably cost about 50 cents.
Yeah.
So yeah. So I made her buy it.
Yeah. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Okay. I like this. My mom doesn't.
I hate this shirt.
It's an Ann Taylor Loft extra large white and black polka dot career shirt, button down front. It's just a basic in a wardrobe.
And what makes you think somebody's going to really want this? Right now the market, the eBay market anyway, is saturated with Ann Taylor and Ann Taylor Loft. We used to both work.
I worked at Bass. You worked at Ann Taylor.
You worked at Ann Taylor too.
I didn't work at Ann Taylor. That was your other daughter.
I'm thinking you did.
Oh, I didn't.
Okay. Stand corrected. Anyway, the market is saturated, so unless it's really a knockout piece, this is just a little polka-dotted blouse. I don't understand.
You know, but I probably weighed so
Do you want
so
somebody
light.
To wear this blouse? And
I need somebody to wear this blouse.
That's what it's always about.
I can photograph it with, like, hot pink pants or lime green pants.
Okay.
Can't you picture? It's so cute. It's just the perfect little crew.
We're hoping somebody else out there can picture themselves with it, so it sells. And what are you going to put that on for?
Probably $10.
Okay.
It's not.
Okay. It might happen.
It might happen. We'll see. I love Lucy's scrub top.
Love this.
Love this.
It love
snaps.
This.
Long sleeves.
Fun this is.
And it really does feel new.
This
I won't advertise
all the chocolates
new.
With Ethel
oh,
on the assembly
yes.
line. How fun is that?
Oh, I didn't realize there were different pictures.
Yeah, very classic. Oh,
oh
she's crushing the grapes.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Who doesn't love Lucy?
Seriously, we all need one of those.
Yeah. Very happy.
You want me to do another one?
Yeah.
The pile's not very big.
Yep.
Okay, this is 511 Tactical. It's a hiking, fishing brand, I guess.
I think
trail.
So. Outdoor.
Outdoor
yeah.
with lots
yeah.
of pockets.
Men's or women's?
I think it's women's. It's women's large.
Okay.
Right? Is that what that
WL.
Means?
WL. Well,
it's
women's
yeah.
large or wide large. I'm thinking
yeah.
women's.
Large. Women's.
Yeah.
And they're in really good shape. They need washed, but... there's
yeah.
no holes
yeah.
or anything.
It's nice quality. Even if you don't know
yeah.
the label sometimes, you can tell
you
by the quality of the material. And a lot of times if I don't know a maker, right away I look at the label to see if the label is quality. Because in my opinion, if something is high quality and they put money into the product, they're not going to put a cheap label on it. So sometimes to be able to tell quickly, I still try to look things up, but I go by the quality of the label
yes.
and say, well, that's a nice label, and the material's nice.
All right, I'll
yeah.
go.
So this is a jersey that Melissa found that I stole. I'm like, give me that.
Where's Sharon?
Yeah. Mitchell and Ness, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It is number 88, Moss. So what is this, football? I'm the least athletic person, and somehow I always pick up athletic golf clubs, tennis rackets. Love that stuff, know nothing
Does
about it.
Does it say what it is on the front?
I don't know.
Football, I think you're right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. And it needs a good washing. But I really think this will do well.
We saw one that went for $100 in the last 30 days.
Yeah.
There was one that
so
sold
So I might have
before.
To split the profits with you.
No, that's good. You gave me a lot of stuff. This, I think you found this and I stole this from you.
Yeah, because I did not like this.
It's black and white stripes with diagonal stripe pockets. It's a plus size and it's very tunic, loose, lagging look.
Does it have a flyaway hem?
Kind of does.
Yeah, if the sides come out to points, right? Isn't that called flyaway hem?
They call it shark bite.
Oh, shark bite is if it goes up, no? And then the points go down?
You're probably right.
Okay.
And it's Ula Popkin.
Yes.
Ula Popkin.
Yeah.
Good for you, Ula.
Yeah. Good for you. I still think that looks like a jailbreak or something. I can't picture a woman wearing that. It's just so...
I would wear that.
You would? That I've never seen you wear that. In my whole life, I've never seen you wear a print like that.
I think
in my mind,
yeah, I wear that. It's so comfy. I can put it on right now.
Yeah, it's so. I dare you. Put that on. No, I'm kidding. Put on.
Okay. Victoria's Secret's emerald lace. It's a vintage robe. It's missing the sash belt. But that doesn't bother me because I have other sash belts that I've collected. Let's see. Does it match my eyes?
Yeah.
Okay.
She doesn't like it. It doesn't look like quality to me. It looks a little bit cheaply made, but the Victoria's Secret's label brings attention. So at least it'll be an item that's visited.
Yes.
So that's good.
Thanks.
Okay. So my next item, Melissa actually found and didn't want, and we're both not big fans of black clothing. Very hard to photograph. Got to have that lint roller out for black, right? And this is a Ralph Lauren blue label, which is not as high as their black label, but still a decent label, right?
It's a vintage label.
Yeah. And it is, what is this made out of? I didn't even check. It's wool? Doesn't
merino
say
that.
Merino wool. And it is a ribbed, body conscious, I'm going to call it turtleneck sweater dress with a lettuce leaf ruffle hem and long sleeve.
Yeah.
Really nice condition. Yeah, really like this dress. So,
how much do you think you'll get for it?
I am going to put this on for $49.99.
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then put it on sale a week later.
Because I'm getting anxious.
Black clothing. Here's a black swim bottom with a higher waist in a plus size, really good condition. So that would probably bring at least 10, 15 bucks.
Yeah, and I bet you that's not in your store a week.
Yeah.
Yeah, bathing suit bottoms especially.
Sell all day long.
Yeah,
that's a fine thing. I loved this. I buy things I love and I'm excited about. So this is green and red. There's a hood.
You know what character this is? Who is the little girl in The Grinch Stole Christmas? What is that called?
Sal?
No,
no, that's
she have
Nightmare
a funny
Before
name?
Christmas.
She's like Mindy Moo or something? I don't know.
Oh.
I don't know what her name is.
Okay.
But yeah, yeah.
Yes. But it looks like an adult size.
If you know that character I'm talking about, leave a comment in the bottom for us.
Yeah.
So
that would be so cute.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm supposed to wear that.
You want me to keep going?
Yeah.
Since I have so much more?
Yeah.
Polo Ralph Lauren. Did we say it was cotton? No, it is Modal wool scarf, and it does have the little polo guy on the front and some fringe, and this will probably go overseas. Most of these scarves for me go overseas. So probably to an Asian place, I would think.
And are you using
like
global
scarf.
Shipping? Are you shipping out globally?
Through
the eBay program?
I do use global shipping, and I also ship internationally by myself, so somebody could choose to use global shipping and choose
for the same country. Say a Japanese buyer saw your scarf.
Yes.
Under their options, they can either purchase through the global shipping program, eBay's,
yep.
and you send it to Kentucky, or they can choose probably a less expensive method
yes.
of you shipping directly, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's
but
great.
I only ship to the UK, Australia, Canada, maybe one other place.
Okay.
Global shipping ships
worldwide.
To, yes.
Okay.
So
okay.
depending on the,
okay.
where they are. You go.
These are a pair of Flax pants. I love the brand Flax. I hated these pants. I don't like the color. They're like this deep brick terracotta color.
It's a perfect autumn color.
Yeah, I'm just not a big fan. But between that and it has slight wear on the crotch, so it will need to be shaved, which I'm a little bit over a lot of care for.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of shaving. I, if things are pilling, I have a tendency not to pick it up. I have about 1,800 items in my store, so I'm kind of over specific little care for each item. But Melissa made me buy this, so we will see how this does.
You couldn't leave them behind.
Yeah, she said you need to get these.
Flax always does. Well.
Yes, yeah, it does. It does.
I have Koi Scrub Top, K-O-I, and they're fairly popular. People collect different styles. I don't know what the style is, but I will look it up. I'm going to say maybe the Bridget. But it has French macaroons.
Yeah, we decided the print is called French macaroon. And look at this little tiny daisy.
Oh,
I love
when
clothing designers put little tiny details, just a little
cute.
Bead. So cute.
Yeah, colors are pretty too.
That should go. Yeah.
Okay.
There goes all your clothes.
Another scrub item: Healing Hands Purple Label Yoga Scrub Pants. So super comfortable, size medium. These should do pretty well. Maybe 10, 15 bucks, I'm guessing. You want me to keep going?
No, I'll do one while you reorganize over
there.
Yeah,
sounds good.
Okay, so this is a Free People, new with tags. I'm going to call this probably olive or lime khaki green, a long sleeve with an open weave crochet lace, and just a thermal top. Now, this was on clearance for $12.99. Whose tag is this? Do you know?
Macy's it. Yeah, that's definitely Macy's.
Yeah. Okay, so it was discounted. So sometimes I will peel these tags off or actually cut the tag so you don't see what it was discounted to.
Yeah.
But it's still considered new because it has half the tag. So I'll have to make that judgment when I list it. But that way I'd bring a little bit more dollar.
So pretty.
Yeah, yeah. I might even, will I keep this? Probably not. It don't look good in this color.
Really?
Yeah, look at that.
That's so good.
How about me? I don't think anybody looks good in this color.
Somebody looks good in this color.
Yes. So if you look good in this color, leave a comment below.
Eileen Fisher Infinity Scarf. It's
not
really
this.
Soft.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't do it infinity waist.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's nice. That was a good find.
Super cute.
Fisher.
Super cute.
Have to look that up, but that might go for $30 or $40.
That's almost like a yoga style. When I see those infinity scarves, I love that look. When a girl wears like a black legging with a freestyle top and then one of those scarves, really comfortable, but it
dresses. Do you use a dress like that?
In my imagination.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Me too.
I'm hoping to.
Corona. I keep pronouncing this wrong. Extra Corona?
Yes.
And it is the whole front, the whole back. That's a lot of logos.
Somebody's going to love this.
She didn't want to buy extra, it. Extra large. I didn't want to buy it.
Yeah.
I don't do great with men's
this
clothing.
This is a perfect
it
beach.
Me.
Like a guy that's spending a weekend at the beach and he's with friends.
Like spring break type thing, maybe?
No, he's older. And he's really cute. He's got a bonfire and, you know, they're drinking Coronas, having a good time, and he's wearing his Corona shirt.
Does he have boat shoes on?
He's barefoot.
Oh. I don't know him.
Okay. I'll have to introduce you to him.
Okay. This is a girl's little shirt. Came from JCPenney, but it retailed for what, $34?
Super cute.
Yeah, so that was cute.
A Christmas winter shirt.
Yes. I'm going to hold that up, and I'll hold this one up. These are both Aeropostale. Is that how you pronounce that?
Aeropostale.
Yeah. I'm not extra sure. Small, both new with tags.
Hey, Monday, you jerk.
Yep. Mine just says Aero, the date.
But really cute.
You should bring 10
So what size is yours? It's just an
extra small.
Oh, okay. So you can lock those up together.
Yeah, I think I will.
Now, what will you ask for the two, do you think?
1967.
What brought that on?
I don't know.
Okay.
A very specific 1967.
Yeah.
Okay, you go.
Okay, this is my favorite find. So love this jacket. This is put out by Chalkline. Did we decide this was vintage?
Yes, definitely
it
vintage.
Seems like it's new without tags. Does not seem to be worn at all.
Yeah.
It is McDonald's employee jacket. Ooh, love that idea.
I know.
I'm convinced that some person that works at McDonald's, maybe a manager or whatever, or even a past employee, will just love this jacket.
Varsity style.
Knit ribbed. Yeah, varsity. That's a good keyword. Cuffs and... Yeah, so what do you think? It's quilted inside. Very clean. It's pristine.
Yeah, it really is.
I'm going to put this on for, now keep in mind I list everything too high, probably $89.99.
Okay.
And then if it doesn't sell, then I'll put it on sale.
I would try it at an auction starting it at that, just in case it is.
Yes. Yeah, when you're not
sure.
There
was one other that went, but it was from the Hamburger University of McDonald's, and it went for about $300. So too bad yours didn't have the hamburger on the back.
Oh, maybe I can get a hamburger patch and sew on.
Another children's item. This is Target brand Cat and Jack in a size small. It's kind of just a knit ivory with a brown fleecy
it's like
collar.
A little preppy guy would wear that.
So
cute. So
cute.
Yeah.
He's going to a ski lodge and he needs this.
I still think he's on the beach.
Everybody's on the beach for me. Feel how heavy it is. It can't be a beach.
It's chilly at night at the beach.
Okay.
And the kids still want to stay out.
Okay.
So, and his pants look
It's not
rolled.
That chilly down here at the beach.
Yeah, no, it's beautiful down here though.
Okay. We'll sell it.
Okay.
Okay. The big money maker here.
Cha-ching.
It is a black slinky knit. It's heavy, kind of, with a diamond-esque money sign and then a big keyhole. This is if you want to show a lot of skin.
Right? If your cleavage is down there, I'm just saying.
Seriously, this is going to be like almost to my belly button.
Yeah.
But it's got ruffles. It's really,
I think
it's really something.
Yeah.
Somebody's going to want this.
Yeah.
That's what my mom said.
And this piece of jewelry here weighs like 2 pounds.
It's really heavy.
Yeah, so you better get a lot because this little
There's no labels in it, but it's very
it's good for a costume.
Substantial.
Yes, yeah,
Simply Southern. I always do well with this brand. This one's a little bit faded, but still I'll get probably 10 bucks or so.
So cute.
Yeah.
And this print, even though this isn't a Lilly Pulitzer, when I see a print that reminds me of a Lilly Pulitzer, I put Lilly Like in the keywords.
Lily-like,
and those have more views, just saying. And I don't know if that's a bad thing to do, so don't do what I do.
But I think it's okay.
Yeah, Lily-like?
Yeah.
Yeah. Super cute.
Then you found these, and I found this one, and they are both fresh produce. I wish they matched, because that would be cute if a mom had those on.
And why didn't I give this to you? Because I would almost wear these myself.
Take them back.
They're size large.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So?
Do you think I'm a size large?
No. I mean, loose and comfy. They're meant to be loose and comfy.
I would probably need a size large. Yeah. At this age in life. Yep.
Yeah.
That's super cute.
Yeah. We like this.
We want to be comfy on the beach.
Teal cashmere. It's a really nice cashmere. You found that too.
I found this one. This label I didn't know, but again, nice label. Black and brown or black brown. It's large men's teal or a turquoise, deep turquoise. Is that what? This is teal, right?
Yeah, I call it teal.
Cashmere. Really nice quality cashmere.
Yeah, it's nice. It's got pillies, but my electric shaver will get those right off.
Yeah, we're going to have a shaver competition later.
Did you bring your cleaner?
No, I didn't. I'm going to buy another one. I have the cleaner from Bed Bath & Beyond. It's just manual, and I love it. It has three different heads to it, depending on the fineness of your material. And Melissa has the
electric shaver from Amazon, which I can post down below if I can figure
that out. Is
that
what it's called? The electric shaver?
No.
Okay.
It is called, it's pink and called the RIWA.
What does that spell?
Riwa.
Rirwa.
Rirwa.
Love it.
But it works really well. That's I think great. It was 10 bucks. You found this too.
I did.
You want to talk about it?
It's just a hoodie. I did not pick it up because it was missing its drawstring. Mm-hmm. And maybe I just wanted you to be able to deal with it.
I'm going to list it without the drawstring.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't like drawstrings. I pull them out of my hoodies.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Okay.
They bother me. They all flip-flop around. Yeah.
Yeah. I just don't want to have too many items with floors in my store. I have about 1,800 items, and I'm going to say about 1,750 at floor. No, I'm only kidding. I don't know. I wasn't feeling it.
Other than the drawstring missing, it's in really good shape.
It is.
This is a brand that used to do really well. It's children's, and it's called Cakewalk. And I don't know if you'll be able to see that, but I looked this up. I might be able to get 10, 15 bucks out of it. It's
really
a Cakewalk. Yeah, with a little, it's got the logo. It's got,
okay.
It's so cute.
I never do children's clothes.
Yeah, I heard that too. But it's really cute. Seriously, I'm talking myself into keeping these. These are vintage Gap overalls in a women's medium, and they're cropped.
We're very excited for cropped overalls here.
Right? How hard is it to find? Not that I've been looking for cropped overalls, but they
you
also
think you're
going to
look poor in those? Like,
I think in the best possible way, though.
Okay.
Like, I could garden in a tank top and throw these on and look very authentic. Like I've gardened
you
before.
You live in a condominium that all of the landscape is taken care of, so I'm not quite sure where you're gardening.
Yeah. In my head.
Okay.
I'm gardening in my head, at least. But aren't they
imaginary gardening?
Yes.
Yeah, they are cute, I have to say.
Yeah, those are worth a buy.
Yeah, and in good condition.
Yes.
Yeah.
Victoria's Secrets, push-up, padded, little swim top.
Yeah, I like the floral petal, petal ruffle.
Really
ruffle petal, I don't know what you'd call that.
And somebody said Victoria's Secret swim is no longer? Is that true?
Oh, I didn't hear
that. They did away with their swim line?
I didn't hear that.
I don't know. Okay, what can you show? You show that.
Okay, this is an open front cardigan. Who's making this? Soma. Soma is really intimates, right?
Yeah.
Soma intimates.
Like bras and camisoles.
But this is
lingerie.
Definitely like a lounge cardigan with, again, flyaway hem.
Super
cute,
comfortable. The black and white print is really pretty.
Yeah.
And it's so clean. Like the knit isn't fuzzy at all.
And some of Soma's things really are items you can wear out on the street, in my opinion. They used to be more just lingerie.
Mm-hmm.
And now it seems to be in the bathing suits, and now, so
good. Good job, Soma.
Yes. High quality.
I also found this pink, and I'm realizing, does this match this?
Oh, I would love that together. That's
right?
Perfect.
They're both Victoria's Secret small.
Yeah, you just need a little
done.
Button. Yeah. Yeah, that's a great thing to put together. Super cute.
You found these too. They are Plowboy, the best in use for farmers, mechanics, and miners, Levi's.
So show them that little label there.
Okay.
That
that's a good call.
I don't know if that's on the screen. I'm hoping it is.
Okay. They have a lot of issues.
A lot.
They have a hole where the pocket tore. They've got stains. They've got grease spots. But they're from the 70s, and I thought it was worth a shot. They're not super heavy denim, so this might be first class, right? We might be able to ship. What do you think?
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
So shipping's 14 ounces. Yeah.
4 or 5. I think I saw that label one other time, and it did
really?
When I first started selling.
Four years ago.
I've
never seen it before.
Pretty sure.
Okay. You can do that one.
Okay. This is Habitat. Clothes to live in. Definitely linen, right? Really
yeah.
Nice. Like a steel gray. Maybe a warm gray.
Rayon nylon.
What do I know?
It feels like linen.
Yeah. Really cute. Lagging look. With these wood buttons.
Where did the buttons go?
Little palm leaf. Are they wood? Oh, no, they're plastic.
Plastic buttons.
I really thought they were wood buttons. I liked them better with wood buttons.
Me too.
I think you need to clip all these up and put some wood buttons on it, because that's what I'm picturing.
Sure, we've got a tree outside.
Yeah.
Just get the saw, make some buttons.
Make sure you wear your overalls.
Those would be perfect overalls for that.
Okay.
Just button-making overalls.
Why am I picturing you in overalls, like with a saw making buttons? Crazy. But yeah, that's what that is. I think this will do well. Lagging look is a good
hair. You can hold her.
Okay.
Then this is also falling apart. It is a backpack, and here is the label.
I don't know the label. Didn't look up the label. We're assuming it's,
it's such
something.
We're experts.
Yes.
I didn't look up any of the labels.
I know, and only one handle works, and then the other has broken off. The whole thing is distressed. But
okay,
it's
let's just
cool.
stop here.
It's so
I'm
cool.
really not understanding and getting any of this. What is attracting you to this falling apart, stained, all the leather is falling apart?
It has a story.
It does, but it's cotton. It would have a better story if it was canvas. Then it would have a real story.
I can picture somebody using this. It's
a boy who went to camp. It
says
camp something or another.
Camp on it.
Yeah. I think his grandmother bought it for him in
1940.
Yeah. No, it's not that old denim.
I don't know.
It could be, because is this real leather even?
It is real leather. Right?
No, I don't think leather breaks like that.
It's not good smelling. Don't smell it. It's really authentic.
Okay.
Like, you can't go to the store and get something like this. Maybe for good reason.
Maybe you would want to. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I wanted to. Okay.
This is a bear I found. Like I said, I'm trying to get acquainted with stuffed animals. I'm not sure I want to, but trying to broaden my horizons. And he is from the Vermont Company. He has tags somewhere. So, Vermont. Teddy bear. Oh, did you hear that, teaching?
We're selling
stuff. Yeah. So she's really cute. Comes with an apron. Yeah. And we looked up comps for once.
Mm-hmm.
And what did we say, 25?
25.
Yeah,
probably.
Jointed appendages.
Yeah,
so you know
cute.
It's a higher quality if they have that. And super cute, but I gave her to you because I'm not bringing her on the plane. I'm not carrying a bear.
You should totally do that. You can put her in the backpack with her head poking out.
Okay. In that backpack?
Yeah, well, not that.
One that actually works. I knew it was all going to come together at the end.
And wear the denim overalls. Come on. You get some stares there.
This is all you.
This is a breast pump by Madura.